Whether you're using a microscope to see the unseen world, or using beakers to mix chemicals to get a chemical reaction, or reaching out to the stars through a telescope, it's time for discovery and learning. It's time for hands-on science.
Hands-on the graduated cylinder.
The graduated cylinder is one of the most common pieces of lab equipment used to measure liquid volume. It gets its name from the measuring lines, called graduations, found along the side of it. Graduated cylinders come in all sizes. Each of them measure a different maximum volume. To use a graduated cylinder accurately, it is important to understand how to determine what the individual marks on the graduated cylinder actually measure. To determine what an individual line means on the graduated cylinder, you first need to find two numbers side by side on the cylinder. Starting at the lower number, count how many lines it takes to get to the larger number. Then, get the difference between the two numbers. Divide the difference by the number of lines you have counted. This will tell you how many milliliters each line represents. In this example, the difference between the two adjacent numbers is 200. Starting at the bottom number, it takes 10 lines to get to the top number. Dividing 200 by 10 gives you an answer of 20 milliliters, which is what each line represents on this cylinder. It is also important when using a graduated cylinder to properly read the volume of the liquid inside the cylinder. When a liquid is in a cylinder, it has a tendency to creep up along the sides. This forms a curved layer called a meniscus. To accurately read the volume of a graduated cylinder, you always read the bottom of the meniscus. Another thing to remember is to never read a graduated cylinder while holding it in your hands. This causes the meniscus to become slanted. The cylinder should always be read on a flat surface to get a proper reading of the volume. Now you know what to do when you get your hands on a graduated cylinder.